Good morning, Shit Zipperers. Today, we're going to look at week 8 in the NBFL. A high-scoring week, except for, like, Sean and me. So, let's get to the highlights. Well, feel the funk back! There were a lot of great games this week, including the Bucks taking down the Chucks by 3 points. Both guys had lots of people who scored, including Horseshoe getting 8 from the Packer defense. But it was Drew Brees, that slick son of a bitch, throwing for 28 points. Mitch again crawled into his arm and peppered him with kisses as Brees wept about the emotion of the moment. Peterson, on the other hand, was livid. He couldn't believe it. He's lost a lot of close games, but who gives a shit? What was easily the week's most exciting game, Beaver Township got 2 points from the Seattle defense, while Poskin got 0 from the Ram defense. One pick, two picks, three picks, a dollar, stand up and holla if you're happy that Chucky didn't win by a frickin' tiebreaker again. Dietrich is looking for great athletes to fill out his roster, and boy did he find one at Megatron. Megatron got a ton of yards. Great athlete, like his owner, is always looking for ways to score. Mike, keep the gun in the holster. You didn't need it this week. It was a tough loss for Chucky and his cheerleaders. In the week's most lopsided game, Doherty Creek got pounded by Apple River 63-25. And let's face it, nobody likes getting pounded by Johnson. However, it has come to the commissioner's attention that Peyton Manning might be part of a neo-Nazi movement based on the signal that he gave to the crowd after one of his games. Manning's ties and MJ's ties go back a long ways. Is it possible that the two of them are part of a white supremacist group? More investigations will follow. In Doherty Creek, Fuzzy's offense looks like a farm accident. The plow jockeys are getting rolled over on a consistent basis. Speaking of farmers, Craig Hammernick's Maple Grove Beefers are getting hot. He spanked the monkey by 10 points this weekend. It was a horrible loss for Upper Turtle, as they were the only team in the Polk Division that suffered defeat to a barren team. Monkey was flabbergasted. But what are you going to do, Monkey? You got Frank Gore, that warrior for good, fighting the evil empire. The week's most heartbreaking loss has to go to Dwayne Talbert and his Yellow River Muskies, who put up 65 points, yet still lost to Smiley Freetag by 3 points. Smiley got 68 and the 10 bucks for the week. Smiley is going to become a Cincinnati Bengals fan and paint stripes on his helmet. He caught a break, however, when Yellow River's Matt Stafford scored 20 points. Smiley, by keeping the red-headed stepchild, known as Andy Dalton, on the bench, squandered away 18 points. The sucker's lucky. He's not that good. The closest thing that anybody in this league has to an automatic win is going down to South Doherty and playing the Mudjackers. Wick Ware's 66 points was a fine effort. South Doherty scored a lot too for them, scoring 28. However, it was Cincinnati's Marvin Jones getting 28 points all by himself. Can you imagine if Sean had won just because he got the tiebreaker versus Marvin Jones? Even Boo Radley felt bad for the hapless owner and cuddled him in his arms. Let's take a look at the updated standings after week 8. It was a tough week for the teams in the Barron Division, except for Craig Hammernick's Maple Grove Beefers, who picked up a game on everybody by beating Upper Turtle. For the rest of the Barron teams, they all were sitting on the fence, making no progress anywhere. It was the teams in the Polk Division that were kicking ass and taking names by piling up points against their Barron brethren. Apple River keeps pace and stays in first place despite being in a three-way tie. Both Wick Ware and Rabbit Trail, they got a lot of points to stay on track as well. The only team that really suffered was Monkey as he slides into last place. The commissioner's office offers you these words of advice. There are many important things in life, but nothing more important than the Northern Badger Football League. Have a good week, everybody.